So basically, we are into MM01.
Yeah.
MM01 we are trying, huh? So raw material is created, or we have to create raw material also?
It was created, but when we were creating, it error was coming, price determination error.
Okay.
Yeah. It was coming for all the metal types.
Storage location is also one problem, right? The field material price determination. This error was there, na?
Yes.
Material price determination control is defined as required field. It does not contain any entry. Which field is that? Material price determination. Material price determination. Price determination, not this one.
Yes.
So same problem is there with your screen also?
Yes.
When you do MN01, you have tried?
Yes, ma'am. Control is required.
If the field is the material group or unit of measure, and the field is not deformed. Material group or unit of weight. So here it is fine. The center. price determination two it is showing with accounting one. Okay, when we have entered that active price. Now
okay.
It is showing. So we will try with this, then we will try with the original thing. This one,
currency convert does
group currency. Now it is creating.
Okay.
Very useless things. So we will try with the standard things. So this material is created, but it is created with some special features. So that we don't want basically. We will create a simple standard material. So we will try again.
transaction based on T-table.
Okay, this field is due to that we have to assign this to discrete now. So, how you will check what material you have created and for which plant?
MM60.
Yeah, this is the T code. So, either you can enter here material. So, material we will not enter because we want to remove the material. So, remove this and go for plant. Enter here plant. Created by So these are the material that I have created. Basically it is displaying here fine, but it is created with that some price constraint, okay? But nothing is displaying here. Normally structure is displaying here for the created material, okay? So basically we have created two material, 91 and 92. Okay?
So I have a query. The material group we entered is 0001. It is a standard one. In case I am starting a new project, and what metal group I will be feeding?
See, material group you will create according to your business requirement. What type of material you have, what type of business you have, according to that you will create a material group.
It is a MM part or it is a PP part?
So both can create that, but basically it's MM part, more than MM part, not PP part, okay? You see, they will create all the master data. Basically material master is the main thing with MM, okay? So MM will configure each and everything, like your material type, your material group, purchasing group, everything they will create, even valuation class. They will create, okay, everything they will do, and you just have to create the material using the SAP data, okay? They will provide you the material type, even the industry sector also,
okay?
Even though evolution. I have,
even a valuation type also,
yes, even though I have, see, means teach you all these things, but it is no use of means as a PP point of view. Okay, so everything will be provided to you by your MM team. They will provide you the material type, they will provide you the industry sector, they will provide you the if external number range is there, so they will provide you each and everything so that you can create your material. Okay,
external number range, what is the benefit of that?
Benefit of that means which one?
External number range, what is the use of that actually?
See, as you know, basically right now the material number you are able to see that these are created by number. Okay. So these are the internal number. Suppose I want to create material which are having the alphabet also. So how you will create that? Because your internal number range will be the numeric only. Okay. In numeric format only. So whenever you want to create your alphanumeric kind of number range, so for that you will have that external number range. Okay. Also, also sometime you will create some test type of material. Okay. For your process testing. So at that time, your external number range will allow you to create your test type material. Okay. So that you can know this is my test material. So with that material, with this number, you are not able to judge that this is my test material or this is my you can say process material, real time material. Okay.
Yes.
This is not, you cannot differentiate here. Okay. So many of the region you can create external number range. Okay. So you have means other format also. See, if you are having your global structure, then you can go EN number also. Okay. So you can have multiple options for that.
Okay, that's why the number from the customer, actually we have the customers like Honda, Suzuki, all that. They have the external numbers in like, they have the alphanumeric customer part codes.
Means EAN.
Yeah.
EAN number.
Yes. They have like ABC and then the numeric code and then another thing. They have the part name like that.
Okay, so this is only the external number range. Okay, this is not EN number range. So EN number range is means it will be created using some different method. Okay, so there is a different configuration for a special type of number range. Okay, that you want to go for. So these are the number range that you can share with your means company standard. Okay. So apart from that, you have other number range also.
EN number range is, what is the use of that EN number range?
So that is your European article number. Okay. In some country, they are using European article number. Means whenever you have your trade with foreign countries. Okay. So they will have this number range like your EAN number, European article number. So basically, when you have import and export scenario, okay, so they will have their number range, you will have your number range. So how you will connect these material? Because same material, they will send you same material, you will receive, or you can say vice versa. Okay. So at that time, how you will know which material is this and they will know which material is this. Okay. So that they will create a unique number range. Okay.
Okay.
So there are different format according to the business requirement. Okay, sometime you don't want to go with this internal external, you want some different number range, or sometime you only want this internal or external number range. Okay, so you can have all the options. Means all the options are used in different business scenarios. Okay, so that you will see with your real time system as you are comparing this now. So my client is having this type of number range. So like this, you will see with other product also different types of number range with material. Okay. So they will be created by your MM part. Okay, MM team will provide you that number.
Evolution type and material type, metal group, this all thing will be created by the MM team.
Yes. For your things, suppose you want to go for variant configuration. Okay. For your configurable material, see, it depends upon your company means process. whether they want to go with PP side, whether they want to go with MM side, because for that process you have to configure the configurable material type also. Okay.
Yeah.
So configurable material type is something different from the raw material and finished material. It is like one of the material type. Okay. So
okay.
What you will do then? See, according to your process, your MM team can create that material type for you. Okay. And you can also create that material type for your requirements. Okay. It
okay.
depends upon the business process. Who will create that? Okay. So basically, I have teach you each and everything because if you have this kind of experiences, sometime you may have MM configuration also with your PP part. Okay. So you should know the thing, it will be good for you. Okay. So basically we have created the material. This is my raw material. All the material. See, this is my finished material, 46. Okay. And we have two raw material also. Right. So other thing that we can do with our material master, another T code that are related to your material master are like your MM01. Okay. With MM01, you will create your material master. So like that, if you want to make any changes with your material, okay. So how you will go for changes, you will use this MM02. Okay. Enter MM02.
Okay.
Press enter. It will give you this screen. Okay. So what you will do here, you will enter here your material number that you want to change. Okay. So I have basically, I have remembered this material only. What was that number? 700. What was that? Actually,
91, I think. 91 or 92.
How many zeros were there? 700.
There was maybe
91. Na? It was 91. It is showing 91, 92. It is not showing.
Ascending. Please do the material in ascending order, then it will be shown. Click on the material first, then it will be higher.
Now it is showing. Suppose I want to make
91 and 92
okay. So suppose this
okay.
is my material with which I want to make changes. So what you will do, you will enter here your material. Now select the views. So you can select all the views, okay, and you can go for any of the view with which you want to make the changes. So enter now your plant, storage location. Okay, so this is my material that I have created. So I want to make changes here. Suppose I want to maintain like what chair, okay. So I have done the changes. So first of all, I will copy this. Now how I will display this changes, okay. So another T code is there, that is /NMM03. With this T code, you will be able to display the material, okay. Might be you have a right to this T code, because generally as an end user or as a power user, you will have this right to view.
If you want to change the base unit or the price, then
yes,
we
yes,
will go to MM02.
Yes, yes. Every field that is enabled to change, okay, that is not grayed, you can change that field.
Okay.
See, like this field, you are not able to make changes, okay? The grayed field will not be changed, and the rest of the things, the fields which are enabled to, means these are white, generally it will be white. And then if then you can go for the changes if you want to do any changes. So now you are able to see we have changed the description.
Yeah.
Now it is displaying here. Okay?
Yes.
So like that you can change the unit also, price also.
Okay.
So basically this is how we will create the material. Okay. So we have seen this MM01, MM02, MM03 and MM60 also, how to display the created material. Okay. So like
MM60,
this
MM60 for the
to display the material.
Display.
List the material. You can say list the material. It will show you see report for your means created material. Okay. Whether you can search your plant wise, whether you can search for your material. Okay. So according to the available search criteria, you can list your material. Okay. And you can know about your material.
There is a query. Query is here to list the material, it is MM60. And where I am working, it is the T code is ZZMM60.
ZZMM60, see what is the difference between this type of T code? These are the customized T codes, okay? The T code which are started with your Z alphabet, or you can say Y alphabet. Sometimes you will have Y T code also, T code is starting with Y and T code is starting with Z, okay? So these will be your customized T code that are configured or customized for your company requirement, okay? So there will be some add-on field also, okay, for that purpose. Yes, so it can be there that for their some add-on field they have designed their new transaction code, so there is a scope that you can create new transaction code also. Okay, so
the new transactions code, the new transaction code will be created by the developer.
Both with the functional as well as the developer. Because you will provide the functional specification, see which functionality do you want to add or do you want to create with that, means whatever process you want to create, and your developer will create according to that specification. Okay. See, OMJJ is the T code with which you can create this. Okay. So these
OMJJ.
Are the fields. OMJJ. Okay. Cluster
yes.
editing.
It is
so
for customization of T codes.
Yes, and without help of your ABAP team, you cannot create your T code, the customized T code.
Okay.
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 So you need ABAP
team
help
will
also.
Record.
Yes. Because anything that is related to development will be directly connected to your ABAP team. Okay. And functional side, you will provide the specification that we need this functionality and we want to add this functionality as per. See, you are as a functional consultant, I will be able to explain for which purpose you want to add this thing, you want to change this thing.
Yes.
So you will provide the table detail also, you will provide the function detail also, and you will provide the purpose also. Okay.
Okay.
So according to that, they will go for the screen design or add-on. They will go to the table and they will make the changes to the web team.
Okay.
Okay.
It is the window. It is displaying. It is OMJJ.
Sorry, OMJJ.
Yes, it is showing moment type, debit, credit, and.
So these kind of things, see, companies is having many customized T-code according to their requirement. Okay. So it will be done with the help of functional as well as the above two. Okay. So any other question, any other thing that you want to know about your material that you are having with your real-time system?
No.
It is clear till material master. So what you have to do now, so you will create some finished material, okay, using your finished material type, and you will create some raw material using your raw material type. Okay? So tomorrow we will have the class, okay? So you will be available at the same time?
At 7.
Sorry?
Yeah, I will be available.
Same time, na?
Yes, on 7 to 7.
Okay. So, we will have a class on tomorrow also. Okay, so, then we can proceed with the next process. Means we will see first master data we have done, that we have created our master. So, after that, we will proceed with the another master data, that is your bill of material. Okay. So, now we will create bill of material, and after that, we will create all these master data we will create tomorrow, and after that we will start the process from Monday. Okay. So we will create bill of material, your log center, your security, everything we will create tomorrow. See, once your material is done, then everything will be possible. Okay. So you create for your practice some raw material and some finished.
Okay.
So is it fine till here?
Yeah, it is fine. It is fine.
So you practice for this, and we will start with bill of
material. For creating FG materials. For creating, where we will define it is FG or is this semi finished or raw.
OMS2.
Okay, OMS2. Yeah.
You will use this OMS2.
A material type.
Sorry, it is not.
MS2. Yeah.
OMS2. You will enter this D code and you will have a list of material type. It will take some time because it will read the data from the table. Okay, so this screen will come. With this screen, you are able to create your own material type, okay, like you have created the raw material. Same way, you will create your finished material. So, for your finished material, your material type will be FERT, okay, that is your SAP standard material type, okay. For finished material, it is FERT. So, whenever you enter this, system will show you FERT finished material. Okay. Then go to the copy option.
And to check the material type I have created, it will be shown in the list over here.
Yes, yes. It will display you with your list. Okay. Suppose you have created some raw material.
Can you
please
go to the position?
Yes. You go to the position.
I have created double FG.
Double S.
Double FG.
Double S G. This one.
Double F F.
F. Okay.
Any F F for Fox.
F F G.
Yes.
It is not there.
It is not showing over here.
Means it is something different.
F Raw. F Raw is there. F Raw is there.
Afro, I think you have created, na?
Afro is there.
Yes, Afro is there. Yeah, like that, Afro. If you create your finished material, it will show you here with the list also. Okay?
Okay.
So, go to the OMS2 first. Yes. Create your own material type. And after that, see, whenever you go for the configurable material, that is very common in PPU. Okay? So, KMAT is the material type for your configurable material. Okay, so it will show you the configurable material.
Configurable material, what does that define basically?
Configurable material, see, whenever you configure your material, means material will have different you can say combination. See, raw material will be same, okay, the component will be same, but the configuration will differ. suppose you have to configure some engine for some car, okay? So your engine
Okay.
will have different configuration, okay? Some can be your 12 cc engine, some can be your 10 cc engine, like this. There will be variation, okay? So for that variation you will have this configurable material. So only your configurable material will have that functionality. With that you can go for the means different variation. So like this you can create your different material type. You can check with your company also. If you check your material list na, so you can check the material type. Okay, so from there you will we try to understand that what are the material types they are using. Okay, try to create here also.
Actually, in the office, these T codes like OMS 2, OMS 3, EC 01.
No, no,
what
you
T codes
use
are
this Z, double Z. What T code is that? Double Z, MM60.
Yeah.
So you use that material.
It shows over there, material type. It shows over there.
Yes, it will display you all the material type that they are.
In double Z, MM60, it shows over there, material type.
Yes, it will list the material type also. Okay, purchasing group also,
yeah,
material group also.
Good.
Okay, so according to that, you can configure your data. Okay,
okay,
clear?
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, so practice for this thing. Okay, and try to have your data, real-time data, and try to create the same thing, okay? And see what are the configuration process that your company is using, okay? So now I am stop sharing.